Hey, this is Swedish Katanod, and you're watching Nerd News! This week's episode of Nerd News I'd like to call The Emperor's New Clothes. I'm gonna talk about some amps from the three big amp modeling companies. It's Line6, Blackstar, and Boss Roland. Since they all have come up recently with new models of their most famous modeling amps. So I'm gonna go through them in from one spectrum to the other, because in many ways they aren't new products really. So I'm gonna go through them and see which is the least a new product. Does that make any sense? So on one side of the spectrum, we have Line6. It's the version 2 of their Spider 5. And the thing with that is that you can actually own the original Spider 5 and download the software update to make your Spider 5 into a version 2 Spider 5. And that makes them the only company that does this. So thank you, Line6. That's very generous of you. And what they have added are new features. I've talked about it previously when I talked about practice amps. Well, stepping towards the other side, we have Boss Roland with a Katana. That's also a Mark II version 2 of that. And here they've changed the hardware, or at least the controller of the hardware. I'm not sure that the hardware itself is changed. I can't really find anything that confirms that. But the actual layout is changed. And they added some effects, and they have added amps as well. So what you have now is twice as many amps. You have more effects, and you have a control panel that makes it easier to control, especially the effects. But otherwise, it's basically the same product. It looks the same, and it probably sounds very much like the original one. They also added a feature where you can go straight into the power amp and just bypass the old Katana thing. Why you ever want to do that? So that's a middle of the spectrum. And then on the far other side of the spectrum, we have Blackstar with the new Silverline amps. And they are looking at them basically a revamp of their ID series. It's the exact same controls. It has the exact same features. In this case, they notify you that they have a new processor running it. So that should make it able to, I don't know, capture the modeled guitar amp sounds better and make them, I don't know, more sound like the original actual amps. The thing that they are doing smart is that they aren't actually pointing at amps when they are modeling it. It's not like, for instance, Line6, where you actually state what amps they are actually modeling. With Blackstar, it's several preamp versions, and there is also several power amp versions. So it's supposed to model both the preamp section and the, how the different kinds of tubes are reacting. But all in all, the control panel is exactly like the ID series. What they did though, and this is a major thing in the guitar world, they made it look vintage. And all guitarists love things that look old and broken. So I guess they're on the right track there. And apparently they have updated the modeling of the amps as well, and have some new amps as well. So one thing that stands out with the Blackstar amps is that they have changed the speakers. So now they are using Celestion speakers. And well, some reviewers, including me, were complaining about them changing to no-name or own brand speakers in their HT series. So I think this is a good move, and you're pleasing the audience. So keep going that way. Three new versions of things that are basically the same as they were before. And yeah, who knows? Maybe they are amazing and completely different from the original ones. I think maybe they aren't. I think Blackstar has made an interesting move, because usually when you have modeling amps, they look kind of black and they look kind of, I don't know, futuristic. So this is an interesting step back. I think Boss has done it before with their Tone Capsule series, and yeah, they have done amps that look kind of vintage, but I think Blackstar's taking it one step further. Feel free to leave a comment about what you like about the new ones, and if you have tried any of them, what you like about them and how they differ. And as usual, if you are representing a company and want your product to be covered here in Nerd News, just send an email to this address. And everyone, just leave a comment and be nice. It's good to be nice. And I'll see you soon. Bye.